ripe old age and then passing quietly in our sleep. That's what we would all like. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, that isn't always guaranteed. And just as Ed said, we really don't know when Gabriel's horn is going to blow. What can we do for ourselves to make sure that we have the best chance of living the longest? Heart disease is the number one killer in America of men and women, blacks and whites. And so what can we do to control heart disease? We often think that a lot of the messages have been put out there already, and a lot of the messages have been heard by people. Whether they've been incorporated or not is a different thing. In the past, say maybe 20 years ago, 25 years ago, and working with groups like the American Heart Association, where we know what's important and what's not important, we'd say that a lot of the general America, so a lot of white America, would know what to do and what not to do, what the risk factors are, but the black community didn't. I would suspect that all of you here are likely to know what the risk factors for younger people are. So those things are legislated that help to prevent things. And what we talked a lot about here, for no matter why you're here at the Black Health Matters Summit, no matter why you're here, you need to learn advocacy for your illnesses, whether it's HIV, whether it's cancer, whether it's heart disease. You need to know how can we get involved to prevent these things from affecting us. And so I typically think of it as on three levels. If you just think about your dentist in terms of keeping your teeth, that typically you have to do something every day. You have to advocate for yourself. So if you brush and floss every day, you'll be, good, right? Then every once in a while, you'll need to go out and perhaps go get checked. So go to the dentist, like twice a year. They look through there, tell you need to do this, do that, get your teeth clean, and get the fillings done. That's good. And then on a higher level, you'll have advocacy, national advocacy, or pretty much municipalities will do things like fluorinate the water. So you decided to fluorinate the water, and that prevents you or children from having cavities because it gets stronger teeth. And so those are the different levels of things that can be done that actually keep you from having tooth decay. And like in the old days where they had painless dentistry, now most of the dentists are looking at cosmetics because there are not as many cavities to fill, right? I mean, some of us are at the age where every time we went to the dentist there was a new cavity to fill, but a lot of younger people can get through and they've never had the experience of having the dentist drill.